गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द क्लास ऑफ HTML. इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस द टॉपिक्स दैट वॉज फ्रेम एंड डिफरेंट एलिमेंट्स ऑफ फ्रेम लाइक फ्रेम सेट एंड फ्रेम. एंड टूडे वी विल कवर पेज नंबर 30 एंड आर टॉपिक्स विल बी एट्रीब्यूट ऑफ द फ्रेम लाइक स्क्रॉलिंग, नो रीसाइज, frame border, border and border color. So students, come to the book. We are having first topic, that is scrolling. What is scrolling? Students, scrolling means this attribute decide that the frame have a scroll bar or not. Means our web page which we have set in at the frame, that will have the scroll bar or not, that is our wish. We can set it with this scrolling element. And the types of scrolling are yes, no and auto. Yes means we need that scrolling should be there, and no means that in our web page we don't need the scroll bar. And auto means it will automatically insert the scroll bar if the web page has more height or width according to the frame. Means our frame is small and our picture is bigger than the frame, then it will automatically adjust the scroll bar. And its syntax is frame SRC is equal to path, that we have discussed in the last lecture. And we will write scrolling, and after equal to we will write yes, no or auto. Auto is by default type of the scrolling, and at the end we will close it. Now see practically that in the last lecture in our notepad we have adjusted three photo frames like the frame sets. We have set the frame set rows 20, 30 and 50, and we have adjusted our three web pages in it. First of all, see its output, then we will set the scrolling. See, in the web page, this web page is having normal size. It is adjusted according to the size. That's why there is no scroll bar. And this web page is bigger than the frame. It is automatically have its scroll bar. Same with this, it also have the scroll bar. Let's suppose I don't want the scroll bar with my second frame, then what I will do, I will open my notepad to do the coding of scrolling. In the second frame SRC, after writing the path, I will give one space and I will write scrolling is equal to double quotes no. I have given with the second frame. Now see what will be the effect of it. I will open my output. See, now there is no scroll bar here. I can't scroll this web page. I have not set with it. That's why it can be scrolled. Clear students? Now next topic in our book, that is no resize. What is the meaning of no resize? No resize make the frame non-resizable by the user, and its syntax is frame source is equal to path, and we will write no resize and we will close our frame. Now again come to the output screen. See, in the output screen, whenever I am placing my cursor on the border, double headed arrow is appearing, and I can see adjust the size according to my wish. Now I don't want that the size should be adjusted in one frame. For that, what we will do, we will open the notepad. Now with the third frame I will write no resize. I can write where I don't want to be resizable, I have used with third. Now see, on the output screen, my this frame having double headed arrow and I can resize it. But with my this frame, double headed arrow is not appearing and I can't change the frame size. Now, next attribute in our book, that is border. What is the function of border? Border display and adjust the thickness of the border around the frames. Whenever we need that the border should appear in our frame, around the frame, then we are using this border attribute. And its function is frame set border is equal to double quotes. We will write that whatever the border we want, pixel, 10 pixel, 20 pixel, 30, 22, whatever we need. We will write over here and we will close it. Now see, in the practical, I will open notepad and in the frame set, I will write border is equal to, let's suppose I will write 50. That is the pixels. I'll save my work. I'll close my notepad and see, the gray color border thickness is 50 pixels. I have given in the frame set, so my all frames borders are appearing. If I will give in a single frame, then that will give in the particular frame. I have given in the frame set, so its width is 50 pixels. Clear, students? Now, next topic in our book, that is border colors. By default, we get the color gray, but I want to change the color of the border. Then we are using the attribute, that is border color. What is the function of border color? This attribute gives the color to the border. Means firstly we decide the border, then we'll decide the border color. And its syntax is frame set border color is equal to color name, whatever the color I want, I can give the name of the color, and at the end we will close the frame set. Now come to the notepad. See, in the notepad, in the frame set where we have given the border, I will click over there, I'll give the space, I will write border color is equal to, let's suppose I want green color. In the double quotes we will write. I'll save my work, I'll close it and see the output. Now the border color is changes to the green color. By default it was having gray color. I have given it the green color, that's why border is coming in green color. Now next attribute in our book, that is frame border. With the border we can give the border thickness, we can adjust the thickness of the border, and with the frame border it will display the frame border. We want to see the border, then we will write the value 1. If we don't want to see the border, then we will write 0 in front of frame border. Means the frame border has two values, 0 and 1. It will show the border and it will hide the border. Means it will display the border or it will not display the border. And its syntax is frame set frame border is equal to 0 or 1. 0 means it will have no border. 1 means whatever the thickness in the border attribute I have given, that will display. Now see, we will open the notepad and we will write frame border. Frame border is equal to 1. 1 means it will display. I don't want, I'll use 0 first of all. 2, not to display. I'll close my work. See, now no border is coming over here. Over there. Now I want the border. Then what I'll do? In the notepad, we will write frame border is equal to 1. I'll save my work, I'll close it, and I will show you the output. See, again the border is visible. So students, today we have discussed different attributes of the frames, like border means the border thickness we can decide with the border attribute, with the border color we can decide the color of the border, and with the frame border we want to see the border or we don't want to see the border, that we will decide. We have done the scrolling, means we need the scroll bar or not, then we can, that we can decide. And with the no resizable means we don't want to resize our web page. Students, we have given you different project works based on the frame and its different attributes. Do that work with the help of Schoollinks. Thank you so much.